हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू डे 5th ऑफ सितंबर लीड कोड चैलेंज एंड टुडेस क्वेश्चन इज ऑल एलिमेंट्स इन टू बाइनरी सर्च ट्रीज. सो द क्वेश्चन सेज दैट यू आर गिवन टू ट्रीज एंड यू हैव टू आउटपुट ऑल द एलिमेंट्स प्रेजेंट इन बोथ ऑफ दीज ट्रीज इन अ सॉर्टेड फैशन. सो लेट्स गो थ्रू द एग्जाम्पल. सो दिस 214 इज द फर्स्ट ट्री एंड 103 इज द सेकेंड ट्री. एज मैंशनड है रूट 1 इज 214 एंड रूट 2 इज 103. You need to output the total elements present in the both the trees in an list in a sorted fashion. So I would like you all of you to just think for a second, how are you going to do this? There are a couple of approaches that may strike you. One of the approach could be you iterate through the first tree, you store all its element in an array. You iterate through the second tree, store all its elements in the other array, and then perform the merge on both the lists that you have created, that you have stored. This is exactly what we are going to do, and it is also stated in the hint here that you traverse the first tree, you traverse the second tree, create a list, and then merge the two trees and sort it. But there's a little trick here. Which traversal will you opt for? Let's go through the algorithm that will help you decide this. Let me just start the slideshow. So all elements into binary search trees. The approach, the traversal that is very specific in this case is an in-order traversal. Why? Because you are given a binary search tree. Whenever you do a in-order traversal for a binary search tree, it gives you the elements in a sorted fashion. So it's an inherent property of a BST that whenever it is traversed in an in-order fashion, it gives you the elements in a sorted order. So if you are unaware of this, I'll walk you through how it works, and then we can perform merging of two sorted lists. So this is another question on lead code. Both of them are like independent questions on lead code. And this question is an amalgamation or the combination of these two approaches. So it's an important question from the interview perspective, because it tells the ability of the interviewee, how is he able to combine two approaches and propose a solution. This example, so let's take this example. This is a binary search tree with the elements mentioned here. Let me just iterate through an in-order fashion. In-order states, you first visit the left subtree, then you visit the node, the info part, print the info part, and then you visit the right subtree. So it is LIR, left info right, or left data right. So you are at this node, this is the root. You see that there is a left subtree of this tree, so this one. So you moved here by recursion. Now you come to 4 and you see again see that it has a left part of it. So you come here, go here, and you see you come to 2 and you'll see that 2 doesn't have 2 has its null as its left child. So you turn back from here, you print 2 as the first element. Then you visit its right child, its null, you return back, and you again return back. Then comes 4, and similarly you go to 5. Then you go to its left part, its null, left child, its null. You print the node 5, and then you visit its right child, its null. You return back. Then you again return back from here, and once this is traversed, return back from here. So then comes 10, and then you iterate through the right part of it. You go here, you see it doesn't have a left child, so it was null. So it returns from here. You print this node, you print 20. Now you visit a right child. Again, you go here, the control goes at 30. It's null, left is again null. It comes back, print its current node, info value. It's 30, then you iterate to its right part, it's null, you return back. So this is what we have created using the in-order traversal. All the elements in this array are sorted in nature. It's 2, 4, 5, 10, 20, and 30. So the complexity for this traversal is order of n, where n signifies the number of elements in the BST. Because you are traversing every element once by the iteration. There are multiple approaches to do this traversal. The easiest one is recursion. We'll go to that during the coding part. Let me just tell you the other part of the question, which is merging of two sorted lists using two-pointer approach. So what do you do in this approach is you have two lists that are sorted in nature, and you want to create a third list, which is the addition of these two lists in a, and the elements are in the sorted order, so that you don't have to resort the elements again. So what you do is you have a start pointer for the first list S1, you have the start pointer for the another list which is S2, and you then choose the minimum of these two. In this case it's 2, so you add it to your into a result array, resultant array, and you iterated S1 to the next pointer, so S1 comes here. Now you have to do a comparison between these two values. S1 comes here, these two values, 4 and 7, you added 4 to the result, and then again S1 moves to the next pointer here, 5, then you again make the comparison between 5 and 7. And again, 5 wins. So 5 being the smallest one gets added to the result. 5 pointer moves again to 10. And then in this case, now the lower value is 7, between 7 and 10. So you choose 7. Then once you choose 7, you add it to your resultant list and you move the S2 pointer here. So S2 comes to 11 now. And then you make a comparison between 11 and 10. 10 wins because 10 is the lower value. And then you move S1 to the next pointer and S2 becomes 20. S1 becomes 20. And then you make a comparison between 11 and 20. So 11 wins. And you move S2 to the next next pointer. S2 comes here. And now you added 11. Now comes an interesting case where both the elements are same. So what do you should do? You should add either of them. You add either one of them. So in this case, let me add S1 here and move S1 to the next point. S1 got added to the list and S1 moves ahead. So I added S1 here. So I added 20 here and S2 stays at 20. Then I make a comparison and add with 10 and 20 and 30. And 20 wins again, and you move S2 to the next point. S2 comes here, and then you make the last comparison as 23 and 30. So 23 wins, you added 23 here, and the last part is whatever the remaining elements are in this array are, you simply add it. It's the last part because this is completely traversed. So if any elements are still there in the array, that S1 has not reached the end of the list, you simply append those elements in your resultant array. So I added 30. What I'm trying to signify is if there are multiple elements like 40, 50, 100 and so on, you'll blindly add those elements at the end of your resultant array. So this is another corner case that you need to consider while merging the two lists. I think I explained the logic now, and let's code it up. One more important thing that I want to tell, what is the time complexity of this iteration? It's order of log of L1 plus L2, where L1 is the number of elements in the first list and L2 is the number of elements in the second list. So it's order of L1 plus L2. Defining the array list 1, that will store the elements for against the tree node for 1 in an in order fashion, and defining the in order traversal method, passing root 1 and list 1. Similarly, defining it for the second tree, passing root 2 and list 2, then performing the merge on both the list 1 and list 2, and returning the result. So this will return the answer for us. Merge will return the list which is a combination addition of these two lists, and the elements are stored in a sorted fashion. So here are two methods that we need to define. The first one is the in-order traversal, private void in-order traversal. Tree node root comma list of integers, and this is a list that is storing all the elements. If root equals equals to null, you simply return back. Otherwise, what you do is you traverse by the left subtree, as we mentioned that it's left info right, passing the list. Then you add the element in the list, the root dot the current value, and you traverse to the right subtree. So we are done with the traversal part. Let's code for the merging part. So private, what it is returning, it's returning your answer list, the merge method. So it takes two parameters. The first one is the list one, and the other one is the second list, list two. And since we need to return a new list, I'm defining the new list. That is my answer. New list, new array list. And I'll initialize my start index. Start one equals to zero. Similarly, start two equals to zero. Defining my len one equals to list dot one dot size. Defining len two. So these are the lengths of the two lists that are passed. What will I do? While start one is less than len one, and start two is less than len two. Till the time both we have not reached the end, the terminal state of either of them. If list one dot get start one is less than list two dot get start two, we need to pick the smaller one. So list ans dot add the smaller value, which is this in this case. You'll increment the start one pointer, else you will choose the bigger value, the other value. So we'll be adding list two dot get two start two, and you'll be updating your start two pointer. We are done here. Now we'll add two more cases where list one. Start one has reached the end of it, while start two is still in the middle. So as we discussed, you need to blindly add the other part, the remaining elements. So you'll simply add it for the case till the time start two is less than list len two, and similarly for the len one part, because we are not sure which list has exhausted by code. So adding it here, and then simply return back the answer. So let me just try this code up. So it gives me all the elements in the right manner. Let me just submit it. I made a typo in the code. I set the length of the list two as list one dot size. I must have done it two. And once I did it, it passed. Sorry for that. Let me just walk you through the time complexity so that we analyze the code better. What we are doing, we have created a list one that will store the elements against the root one, tree one, in an in order fashion. Similarly, list two stores all the elements against the root two in an in order fashion, and then we are performing merge operation. In in-order traversal, we are going to its left subtree, adding the value to the resultant list, and then traversing the right subtree. All elements of the tree are traversed once, so the time complexity for the traversal is order of n. So where n signifies the number of elements in the tree, so the complexity is order of n. Similarly, the complexity is order of number of elements. So let me just call it n1 and n2. And let's talk about the merging part. So all the elements again are traversed once in both the list, list 1 and list 2. Hence the traversal time will be order of n1 plus n2. So this will be order of n1 plus n2, which actually signifies the total number of elements present in both the trees. Number of elements in both the trees. Thanks for watching the video, and if you have any doubts, please feel free to comment.